So today I'm gonna be placing the hard drive, my good old Mac SE. As you can see, it's not booting from the hard drive. The hard drive that's currently in this is stolen from a Macintosh 2, which isn't working at all. And it's the same style as the original hard drive, which is only 20 megabytes. The one in here is 40 megabytes. The one I'm going to be replacing it with is 80 megabytes. I'm hoping that works. I'm hoping there's no issues or whatever. I did notice that the connector for the LED is different, so I'm hoping that won't cause a problem. And while I'm at it, I'm going to install the math coprocessor. So let's get into it. Alright, so this is a 1987 Mac SE. These old Macs are pretty easy to take apart if you have the right tool. Pretty much the only extra tool you need is this. It's just a long T15 screwdriver. And the back should just pop off like that. I'll remove this metal shield. Don't touch this if you're taking one of these apart. Usually you're supposed to discharge it, but I'm lazy. So I'm just going to not touch it. Removing this bit isn't actually necessary, but it makes it a whole lot easier when you're putting it, or when you're taking out the hard drive caddy. I'm not sure why. Just kind of in the way. I think it's there for if you have like some kind of card that has extra ports on it installed. So I'm just gonna unplug these cables. Oh right. This Mac actually has an expansion card in it. It's just like I'm not sure exactly, it's an accelerator card, I think. Not sure what the deal is with it. It doesn't fit very well, so it's like kind of in there, but you have to actually put it in before you put the board in. That's where the math coprocessor goes. This is the board. This is stolen from a Mac 2SI. Pop that right in there. And I did a test, and this card actually does make the boot process about 15 seconds faster. Not a huge difference, but difference nonetheless. Also, this board had a capacitor-style battery on it, and I replaced that with a battery holder, and a half AA battery. So that works a lot better, I think. Right now, I gotta just unscrew these screws. For the longest time, the floppy drive didn't work in this, and it's kind of difficult to find an 800K floppy drive, because they only had them in the Macs from, I think, 85 to, 89, sometime around then. And the older Macs are more rare and more expensive, so I wasn't going to buy a whole Mac just so I had a new floppy disk, but somebody gave me a bunch of old Macs, a bunch of Mac 2s mostly, for free, and one of the Mac 2s had a 800K floppy drive, and it didn't work, so I just stole that from that one. Alright, so here's the hard drive assembly. I'm not sure how I'm going to get the LED to work, because it's got a different connector on it. But I'm gonna try. don't really have the skill necessary to desolder this or anything. So I think I'm just gonna, like, to put the other connector on, I'm just gonna bend it up and just jam it in there. Well, if it doesn't work this way, I've got another caddy, original one. It's got the production code. It says it was made June 22nd, 1988, which is why I made that 30th birthday video. That one doesn't fit in this. Huh. Alright. Guess it's only gonna be held in by two screws. May not be pretty, but as long as the hard drive works, I'm alright. I think this is also the ribbon cable from the Mac 2, because it's way longer than it needs to be. Before I put that all back together. Okay, so kind of have to line this up with the, just have to hang it there, kind of. Connect the speaker cable. I think that's all you need to turn it on. So let's try it out. See if anything goes bang. These Macs seem, or at least this Mac seems like it's very good at protecting itself from breaking. I had the card plugged in wrong once, and it just kind of, like, it just didn't turn on. It didn't break the card or anything. Hard drive spins right up. I don't think it'll boot, though, because it's got a OS for a Mac 2, and it's also newer, I think. Hey, nice. Does the light work? No. Yeah, it's got the minimal for a Mac 2, which is not going to work for this. Hard drive works. Got a quick flip the cable for the hard drive light. Alright. Let's try this again. Alright, let's try it again. See the hard drive light? No light. Maybe this just doesn't work. Oh well. Wait, yeah, it does. Cool. Alright. That's a success right there. Now I'm gonna screw in the hard drive. Alright, I think this thing is done. Alright. So there's this really cool piece of tech, it's modern tech for these old Macs that I own. It's called the Floppy Emulator, and it does what it says it does. It emulates floppy disks. It's plugged into the floppy port on the back, and you can just, like, yeah, use floppy disks, but, like, you don't actually have to have them. So, a great way to pirate software, get software from modern Macs, modern computers in general, to these old ones. Very handy. It's kind of expensive. It's like $100. But it's a lot less expensive than getting a bunch of 800K floppy disks. This hard drive is so quiet. Wow. Like, really quiet. This hard drive is. This is the original one. It's very loud. It's got this moving thing here. I'm not sure what it does. It's like a stepper motor, and it turns pretty rapidly, like back and forth, while it's running. I'm not sure what that's for. This one doesn't have that. This one's quieter, not a whole lot though. It's a little newer, but it failed on me, so. Yeah, thanks Quantum for making such bad drives. Hard drive 8, hard disk 80. Let's see what's on this. Solitaire Till Dawn, Trash, Applications Norton, blah blah blah. After Dark. That's pretty neat. I like the After Dark too though. Runs better on these old ones, again. Or just a speed thing for these old ones. I'm just gonna erase this because, again, it look. Oh, what? Unable to unmount drive. A file on the disk may be in use. Oh, come on. Guess I'm just gonna have to erase it manually. Manually. Yeah, I'm gonna put a magnet up to every single sector on the disk. Now I'm gonna. Oh, it's not showing up now. Alright. Try it again, maybe. Come on, what? Aw, man. This mouse really doesn't like the carpet. Just getting lint all over the ball. Didn't actually work like at all, so I'm just gonna boot from the floppy here. Alright, boot from the floppy, not from the hard drive, because there's nothing on it. You doofus. Alright, there we go. Installer, let's go. Right. Go. There's Mac OS 7. Well, thanks for watching, you guys. That's how you replace the hard drive on a Mac SE.